हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज कैपिटल गियरिंग रेशियो। फ्रेंड्स, कैपिटल गियरिंग रेशियो इज द रेशियो ऑफ द अमाउंट ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स फंड टू द अमाउंट ऑफ फिक्स्ड इंटरेस्ट बेयरिंग फंड्स। द टर्म इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स फंड्स इंक्लूड्स शेयर कैपिटल, शेयर प्रीमियम एंड जनरल रिजर्व्स। द टर्म फिक्स्ड इंटरेस्ट बेयरिंग फंड्स इंक्लूड्स प्रेफरेंस शेयर कैपिटल विथ फिक्स डिविडेंड पे आउट, डिबेंचर्स एंड टर्म लोन्स। द फॉर्मूला फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग कैपिटल गियरिंग रेशियो इज इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स फंड्स डिवाइडेड बाय फिक्स इंटरेस्ट बेयरिंग फंड्स। अ कंपनी इज सेट टू बी हाईली गियर्ड if the share of fixed interest bearing securities in the total capital is very high. In such a scenario, this ratio is less than 1. On the other hand, a company is said to be low geared if equity shareholders' funds constitute a higher percentage of total capital. In such a case, this ratio is higher than 1. Friends, now I am going to give an example which will make the concept of capital gearing ratio very clear to you. Equity share capital is equal to rupees 7 lakh, 10% preference share capital is equal to rupees 3 lakh, 6% debentures is equal to rupees 3 lakh. So capital gearing ratio is equal to equity share capital, which is 7 lakh, divided by fixed interest bearing funds, that is preference capital 3 lakh plus 3 lakh rupees of debentures. So 3 lakh plus 3 lakh is equal to 6 lakh. So capital gearing ratio is equal to 7 lakh divided by 6 lakhs. Equity share capital divided by fixed interest bearing funds. Equity share capital is equal to 7 lakh divided by fixed interest bearing funds is equal to 6 lakh. So capital gearing ratio is equal to 7 divided by 6. This means the company is low geared since share of equity funds in the total capital is higher than fixed interest bearing funds. So friends, I hope you have understood the concept of capital gearing ratio. And that's it for now. And please continue watching my channel for more videos and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.